Hello guys, welcome to Algorithms Made Easy. My name is Rajat and today we will be discussing the question Flatten Nested List Iterator. In this question, we are given a nested list of integers and each element is either an integer or a list whose elements may also be integers or other lists. We need to implement an iterator to flatten it. So there is one constructor and two methods that we need to implement. In the first example, the nested list is given to us and we flatten it. And the output is in the sequence 11211. And similarly in the example 2, the given constraints tell us about the length of the nested list and the values that the nested list can hold. Now we'll see what this question is about and we will try to visualize this nested list first and then we'll discuss how we can solve it. So taking the first example, we have this as a nested list, but in this text format, it is difficult to visualize a nested list. So let's draw this nested list first. When we draw this nested list, we see this kind of structure wherein we have three indexes. At the first index, there is a list which contains two values, 1, 1. At the second index, that is the index 1, we have the value 2. And index 2 contains yet another list with two values in it. Now, in order to increase the complexity of the problem and to see how much complex this list can be, we will introduce two lists inside this first list. In these two lists, they will contain two more values in each of the list, that is 3, 4 and 5, 6. Now let's see what the iterator should return in each case. When we will try to flatten up this list, we will first get the value 1. Then we will go deep inside this particular list and print value 3. Then the value 4 should be printed. Then 5. Then 6. Then as no value is present after this 6 in this particular list in the index 0, we jump to index 1, print the value 2. And then we move to the other list at index 2 and print the two values 1 and 1 sequentially. So at the end, we get this as the flattened list or the result that we will be printing. How about we create this list at the very start of the program? That is, we iterate through all this nested list in the constructor itself and flatten up this list, create an array list out of it. And then we just need to return element based on the index and we can increment the index. So this solves us much of the problem about the two of the method that we need to implement, that is hasNext and next. hasNext will check if the current pointer is less than the size and the next method will directly return the value present at the current index. Now, how we can flatten up this list easily? So, in this particular problem, we see that there are only two possible cases for any particular position. The value can either be an integer or the value can either be a list. Let's take up each of these cases one by one. When the value was an integer, we were directly putting up that value into the list. So that is pretty straightforward. Now, what about when the value was a list? When the value is a list, inside this list contains some integers and some can be list as well. When the value is an integer, we can directly put that value into the resultant list, while when they are a list, we need to iterate those lists again. So inside this parent list, that is at the index 0, we are effectively doing the same thing what we did in the initial list. So for every value, we need to call the method again to flatten up the value. And so this becomes a recursive approach for us. Now it's time to see this particular approach and we'll see how we can code that. Before moving to the coding part, let's first see what this nested integer of which we contain a list has predefined methods in it. So there are three methods that are predefined in this particular nested integer interface. First method is isInteger, which returns if the value is an integer or not. In the case of an integer only, it will return true, otherwise it will return false. Now there is a second method, which is getInteger, which returns an integer value when there is integer present, Otherwise, it returns a null in the case of a list. Now, in order to get the list, we have a third method called getList method. So, this method will again return us a list of nested integer. Now, let's jump on to the part where we code this particular problem and flatten up this particular nested integer list. So, we discussed that we will flatten up this particular list at the very start of the application. So, we can just flatten the list at the start. So we will initialize this list. Now we need to flatten up this list. So for each of the value present in this nested list, we will call up a helper method wherein we pass the integer. Now we will define this helper method. So we discussed that there can be two scenarios. Either this value can be an integer or this can be a list. So we check if this value is an integer or not. So we have a method called isIntegr. We will call that to check if this value is an integer or not. If this value is an integer, we discuss that we will just simply add this value into our flattened list and we can get the value of the integer by calling getIntegr. Otherwise, we are sure that it is a list. If it is a list, we need to do what we did over here. We can simply copy paste this code and here it will be value. So for each of the values, we will again call the helper. It will add the value repeatedly. So we have a flattened list with all the values present. We just need a current pointer initially be 0. In order to return a value, we can now simply return the value from the flattened list, getting the value at this current pointer. And also we need to increment this current pointer for the next part. And for the next, we discuss that if this current is less than the size of the flattened list, then we are sure that the next value is present in this particular list. Otherwise, it is not. So that completes the coding part. Let's try to run this code for the sample test cases. So we need to get the list from this value. And in order to get the list, we have this getList method. So now let's try to run this code. So it ran successfully. Let's try to submit this. So it got submitted successfully. The time complexity of next and hasNext is O of 1, while that of the constructor is O of n, as we are iterating for all the values in the constructor itself. Once you have solved a particular kind of problem, I highly recommend you to solve 2 or 3 similar kind of problems so that you clearly understand how to approach these kind of problems. So we have also made a video on one of a similar looking problem, which is flatten a multi-level doubly linked list. The link is at the top and in the description below. I highly recommend you to try that problem by yourself. And if you are stuck, the video is right here. Do let us know your thoughts in the comments below. Thanks for watching this video. See you in the next one.